We're here at OSCON 2014 making our way around, and we are here with Karen from the Software Freedom Conservancy. I know nothing about your organization, so this is going to be either the world's best interview or the world's worst interview. So tell me from top to bottom what your organization is, what it does.
Absolutely. So the Software Freedom Conservancy, we shorten to Conservancy, so we avoid all the alphabet soup. Conservancy is the nonprofit home for over 30 free and open source software projects, so many of which you have heard of and probably using, like Git, Samba, Wine, Inkscape, phpMyAdmin, Selenium. I'm blowing your mind.
Yeah,
I mean, we've got a ton of free software projects. They're all really great, and we are their nonprofit home, which means that it's sort of like analogous to like a division in a corporation. Each project is actually a part of our organization, and we provide all the infrastructure that they may need, any legal help. So for some of them, we run conferences. We sometimes hire developers. So yeah, it's pretty cool.
Wow. So if Inkscape wanted to have the Inkscape Designer Conference, that's something that's incredible. Now, what does a project have to do? What would they have to pay to get that kind of service?
Oh, well, so we have an application process. We have an evaluation committee. We're a charitable nonprofit, 501c3. So what a project needs to do is to be a community free software project and join us. And no fees are required to join us, but there are fees in order to do the things that they want to do. And then we take an administrative fee so that we can do all those things for them. But then we maintain directed funds. So other organizations in our space do sort of similar things. Like there are other umbrella organizations like Apache Software Foundation, but we're different from them in a bunch of ways. But one of them is that our projects can get directed donations. Mm-hmm. So if a project is, so like for example, Git, if you want to give $20 to Git, you can just give it to Git and we maintain a fund for them, and sure. And we handle all the administrative and financial stuff around that. So we also don't require any particular licenses. So some of our projects are permissively licensed and some of them are copyleft, and people have very different attitudes, but we're like a very inclusive umbrella, so it's really, really fun. And I actually was a co-founder of Conservancy back in 2006 when I was a lawyer at the Software Freedom Law Center. And then I went to GNOME, and now I'm I've only been at Conservancy for 4 months.
So you said a ton of different things that I have to touch. I'm trying to back up and hit it on piece by piece. So starting out, you said that you provide you will provide infrastructure. So what things other than, let's say, hosting a conference or scheduling a conference, what do you mean by infrastructure?
So we'll hold domain names. We will handle all the financial stuff, which turns out to be a massive pain. We file all the tax forms and all that stuff. We handle all trademark things, so holding the trademarks and stuff like that. And then anything else that needs to be done. So, for example, booking travel to go to conferences. Basically, anything that a free software project might need to function, we'll take care of. We're the corporate form.
That sounds outstanding. Now, when you talk about... You said that you're a lawyer by trade.
Yes. Okay. Well, I'm executive director of the organization, but I am also a lawyer. No tomatoes.
Yeah.
But I only do sort of pro bono legal work. But obviously, some of what I do is a legal role. Conservancy also has a general counsel, so we have dedicated legal help. But I am a lawyer by background, and I'm still do pro bono legal work for the FSF, for a little bit for the EFF. I'm pro bono general counsel for questioncopyright.org. So I'm giving you too much for one interview. Yeah.
No, not at all. I think that it is often undervalued. Like, a lot of people have heard of Inkscape. A lot of people use Inkscape. I use Inkscape, right? But the fact that you provide such a crucial backbone to making the Inkscape project available to people like me, and I didn't even know you guys existed, much less provide it, I think that's hugely undervalued. And I kind of wanted to touch on that in regards to what kind of legal help does... I think a lot of people think that a free software or GNU licensed software wouldn't really have a whole lot of legal battles, but I take it since you have a legal division, a counsel, general counsel, that's not necessarily the case. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's one person, but there are a lot of legal needs for free software projects. I mean, for starters, free software itself is so predicated on legal concepts that a lot of legal stuff comes up. Sometimes there are some licensing problems where, small pieces of the software will need to be relicensed. For one of our projects, we implemented a DCO and other safeguards, basically, so that we can make sure that there are the legal mechanisms in place that the project needs. And that's always different from project to project. So the way we run Conservancy is to very organically look at the projects that are in Conservancy and develop mechanisms that fit their needs. So sometimes it's basically answering questions. The trademark stuff, that's something that a lot of projects need.
Uh-huh.
Yep, it's a place where a lot of projects run into trouble, actually. And so with conservancy, trademarks are held in a neutral place, and it avoids problems down the road. But there is a lot of legal work in making sure that everything is done and it's done right. And then we need legal counsel for things like reviewing contracts and terms
right.
of service.
Right.
And yada, 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 yada. And
yeah, no, it does, and I understand that simply navigating the patent and trademark system that's like a professional in its own, just to be able to do that, and that's a service that you provide to these projects that are on board with you.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's hard to actually predict what kind of needs a free software project will have as it goes along. Each project is different, and if they try to accomplish different things. But what's great about having so many projects under one roof is that when we come up with the problems that happen over and over and over again, there's synergy, and we can handle each of them much more efficiently. So I think it's pretty great. We are accepting new projects, so you can apply. Go to sfconservancy.org and check out what we do and who we are. And in order to join, you must be a free and open source software project, and you must have an independent community and all that good stuff.
That's outstanding, and you kind of preemptively answered my last question, which is going to be where can people go to find out more about that, but I'll rephrase the question and say, where can people go to contribute to the software, you know, Freedom Conservative, if they wanted to contribute money to, you know, to help out what it is you're doing?
Just go to sfconservancy.org/donate. We would really appreciate any donations that we can have. We're a lean nonprofit trying to do everything we can with as little as we can. So we would really appreciate that.
Outstanding. Well, you know, we really appreciate you coming on camera, and you can certainly expect a donation from me. Thanks so much for taking time
Thank
to talk
you.
With us.